Welcome to the Wacker Neuson product world. We will show you how to properly operate our products. But the most important thing first, wear the personal protective equipment obligatory for this machine at all times. This is for your own safety. The helmet protects from falling objects on the construction site. Appropriate protective gloves prevent injuries to the hands. Safety shoes with integrated steel toe caps protect your feet. With the safety glasses, you protect your eyes from particles flying around. The ear protection protects your ears and eardrums. About the machine, check the tire pressure with an air pressure gauge. Refer to the operating instructions for the correct value. Turn the battery disconnect switch to this position. The machine is now ready for operation. When opening the window, make sure that it is correctly secured with a firm click. Now set up your workstation. First, adjust the seat to suit your body size and weight. Then adjust the steering wheel for tilt and height, and the mirrors so that you always have a clear view. Now fasten your seatbelt. Turn the ignition key to start the engine. On machines with a mechanical handbrake lever, be sure it is engaged before starting the engine. Step on the brake pedal before releasing the handbrake. Then select the direction of travel, forward or reverse, with the orange thumb wheel on the joystick. To switch off the hydraulic functions of the lifting arm for road travel, press this red key. The basic functions of lifting, lowering, retracting, and extending are controlled with the joystick. The second gray thumb wheel on the joystick controls the telescopic cylinder. When the machine approaches its load limit, an audible and visual warning is given. In general, make sure that loads are always moved as close and as low down as possible to the machine. To deactivate the overload cutoff for a short time, press and hold the button. Attention! There is a risk of tipping over. The vertical lift system, or VLS for short, is an assistance system for greater safety and comfort. In stacking mode, the machine automatically telescopes the arm out and guides the load upwards close to vertical. When lowering, the telescopic arm is also automatically retracted to keep the load as close to the vehicle as possible. Bucket mode is the second VLS mode. Here, telescopic arm extension is not automated and you extend it manually. When lowering, however, the telescopic arm is automatically retracted again to keep the load as close to the vehicle as possible and avoid the risk of tipping over. To remove the attachment, press the two hand control button and simultaneously open the lock with the third control circuit. Now you can park the attachment. Picking up the attachment. Drive up to the attachment and pick it up with the quick hitch plate. Then activate the third control circuit to lock the attachment. Check that the attachment is correctly locked. The hydraulic attachment hoses, such as 4-in-1 buckets, can be connected to the couplings here. For continuous hydraulic operation, press the button on the keypad and then select the flow direction on the joystick. Steering mode adjustment. When you change to all-wheel steering, the rear axle moves in an offset manner from the front axle. When you change to front wheel steering, the tire position on the rear axle does not change. When you change to crab steering, the rear axle moves according to the front axle. All wheel steering for optimum mobility. Front wheel steering for road travel. Crab steering for precise maneuvering. To park the machine safely, place the bucket level on the ground. Switch the travel direction to neutral and secure the machine with the handbrake. You can then switch off the engine. You will find detailed information on this and the operating instructions. Do you have any questions regarding commissioning or the unit? Speak with your personal contact partner. They will be happy to help. Further information can be found at www.wackerneuson.com.